the concept of pitching an idea as, oh, it's this meets that, not always.
No, people like to do that because it sounds like a shorthand for a movie. E.T. meets Star Wars. But the truth is, people still look at you and like, well, what does that mean?
Yeah.
What are you saying that, and they're trying to figure it out. I mean, I once got famous for 15 minutes when we went into New Line and we pitched a genetically enhanced guard dog that really gets like superpowers. It was a really silly idea, but it was funny. I mean, not funny, it was meant to be low budget horror because the dog gets very scary when it gets out of control. And they said, well, what kind of movie is it? And I said, it's sort of Jaws on Paws. Well, it sounds good, Jaws on Paws, because it rhymes, you know. But it was easy for the executive to walk into his boss,
yeah.
And they said, well, what did Bob pitch today? Well, he said it was kind of Jaws on Paws. You know, it's a shorthand way for pitching. So if you have an idea, and then you can summarize it, but I wouldn't suggest to people that they think they're going to sell something by saying it's going to be E.T. meets Grease.
It's maybe the bookend of your pitch.
Yeah, sometimes you say, I might catch myself saying it sometimes just for fun.
Yeah.
I'll say, I guess in Hollywood terms, you might say it's Star Wars, da-da-da.
Mm-hmm.
But I wouldn't walk in. It's the same thing as walking in and saying, I've got this movie, and it's like Julia Roberts and Tom Cruise. Well, they know you don't have Julia Roberts and Tom Cruise. So if you want to do that, you should say, I'd love to see this kind of movie made with someone like a Tom Cruise and someone maybe like a Julia Roberts. You want them to picture it. But you don't want to act like you've got it in the bag, because
right.
They know you don't, and it sounds like a cliche.
Right.
So I think you have to be careful and really focus on your premise. That's the thing they want to hear. They want to be able to repeat your premise to their bosses, and if you're being confusing or if it's not high concept, look at Tootsie, Academy Award-winning movie, but it's really just a gimmick. I mean gimmick in a good way, because it's like an Academy Award type of movie with great writing, but it's a guy who puts on a dress. That's the gimmick. And I'm not suggesting that everybody go home and try to write a script about a guy who puts on a dress, because you won't sell it that way. But Tootsie sold it because it was an angle on that subject matter. He can't get a job as a famous actor to become an actor. So he switches and tries anything and becomes an actress, because he can't get hired as an actor, so he'll put on a dress and be an actress, and then all the complications happen. But that was no different than years before when Tony Curtis and Jack Lemmon did it in Some Like It Hot. So Tootsie was just a new incarnation of an idea that always works. Robin Williams did it in Mrs. Doubtfire. In fact, I would say, to contradict myself, a new take on a guy putting on a dress is probably a good idea.
Sure.
But what's the angle?
It's got to be new.
That's still got to be new.